Mary Namala and Simon Kaketo, residents of Wachiso District, are the parents of the 17-year-old Agnes Namuli, not her real name, who was allegedly raped in the month of June this year while returning from school. Though the culprit, who happens to have been the school football coach, was put under custody, the parents say they are living under a difficult situation with their daughter. They are worried that their daughter might have caught HIV/AIDS from the criminal, though they have to wait impatiently for 3 months to elapse, as advised by medical personnel, to further carry out a blood test. But what hurts the parents most is the way the school children, villagers, and the family of the criminal have gone ahead to demoralize their daughter, something which has made her hate school and even uncomfortable at home. It is against this background that the parents, together with human rights activists, have dragged government to the courts of law for failing to put in place shelters for women who have been raped or defiled. These activists want the judiciary to make government accountable by directing them to put in place shelters for women who have suffered violence to find refuge and psychosocial support.
That is in violation, and this omission is inconsistent with Article 33 of the Constitution, which makes it a mandatory requirement on government to make sure that it puts in place facilities and opportunities for women to realize their full potential.
They also challenge the unequal punishments that the law provides for sexual offenders as being unjust. The Constitution mandates the state to put in place facilities to enhance the welfare of women to enable them realize their full potential and advancement. But on failure to do so, this is a clear violation of women's rights, as guaranteed under Article 33(2) of the 1995 Constitution of Uganda. Report by Jaliat Namoya for Urban TV.